Good day, everyone. We are once again here to assemble a digital clock with temperature display project. Let us start.
It's been a long and winding journey, but I'm finally here tonight. Picking up.
Mount the IC holder and be sure to follow the orientation mark on the PCB and the IC holder. Solder the connections and make sure that no bridge connections or shorted connections are created. Inspect the connections thoroughly. After that, prepare and arrange the other components and materials. This is to speed up the process of mounting and soldering the components on the PCB. Now mount all the resistors on the PCB. Make sure that you have identified the correct value of each resistor. Then solder the components and cut the excess terminals.
It's not the flowers wrapped in fancy paper. It's not the ring I wear around my finger. There's nothing in all the world I need when I have you here beside me. Here beside me. So you could give me wings to fly and catch me if I fall, or pull the stars down from the sky so I could wish on them all. But I couldn't ask for more, 'cause your love is the greatest gift of all.
Now insert the capacitors on the PCB. Be sure to identify the correct value of capacitance. Solder, then cut the excess terminals.
I close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me, that I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's.
For the first IC, be sure to follow the orientation mark placed on the PCB and on top at one corner of the IC. Look on the white dot. Since it is a surface mounted IC and it's very small, make sure that the tip of the soldering iron is clean. Be extra careful in applying the solder. Make sure that no bridge connections or shorted connections are made.
Not sure if you know this, but when we first met, I got so nervous I couldn't speak. In that very moment, I found the one, and my life had found its missing piece. So as long as I live, I love you, we'll have it.
Now, mount the USB terminal and solder the terminals on the PCB. Continue with the two micro switch and solder the connections.
Ako'y sa'yo, ikaw ay akin. Ganda mo sa paningin. Ako ngayon'y nag-iisa. Sana ay tabihan na.
For the transistor, just follow the orientation that can be seen on the PCB, then solder the connections.
Kung hindi rin lang ikaw ang dahilan, pipilitin ba ang puso kong hindi na masaktan? Kung hindi ikaw ay hindi na lang.
Mount the battery component and the battery holder. Make sure that the polarities are observed and followed.
What if I never knew? What if I never found you? I never have this feeling in my heart.
Mount the remaining components, the crystal oscillator, the LDR, and the thermistor. Solder, then cut the excess terminals.
She's always on my mind, from the time I wake up I close my eyes. She's everywhere I go. She's all I.
Mount all the red LEDs. Be sure to follow the polarity. The longer terminal is the positive terminal, which you need to place on top or on the holes on the outer circle. Now continue mounting the LEDs. This time, all the blue LEDs. Solder the terminals and cut the excess.
There goes my heart beating, 'cause you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. Please come back now. And there goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless now. I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I.
Now mount the 8-segment display. Solder the connections and cut the excess terminals. Now, after inspecting all the connections thoroughly, place the main IC on its holder, following the orientation found on the PCB and on one end, on top of the IC. Now, place the battery following correct polarity. And now, you're done with your digital clock and temperature display project assembly. Testing the project functionality will follow. Good luck! Now we are going to test if our project is working. So as you can see, our project is here and okay, so we will need a USB cable, okay, for us to test this project. Okay, so you can use your charger, maybe, no? So if you want to test this one, so as for me, I'll insert it in my laptop. But for safety, okay, maybe you can simply use your charger first before your laptop, okay? So that you will make it sure that this device will not damage your laptop, okay? So if it's already working, so you are confident that you can use your laptop for this one. Okay, so as you can see, so it's working. So every 10 seconds, no, the temperature, okay, the temperature will be shown on the screen. Okay, so there it is. Okay, so if you want to adjust the time, okay, there are 2 switches at the back that you can use. Okay, you can simply press them. Okay, so when you press the second button, you will see that the minute clock will blink. It means that you can have it adjusted. The same thing with when you press it again, the button that you use to blink the minute, okay, it will transfer to the hour timer, and then there you can adjust the time for the hour. Okay, so this is it. So we have another working project. Good job.